how important was his wife in his life?
Totally. You know, everything about Steve is the connection of sort of the romantic, sort of ethereal, poetic side of Steve and the realistic, smart, sensible,
solid side.
He
says this extraordinary line in the book. If I can read the connection. Well, yeah. I'm going to read you just a line from the book, because I think this tees it up nicely. We didn't know each other 20 years ago. We were guided by our intuition. You swept me off my feet, he says. It was snowing when we got married at the Atwanee. Years passed, kids came, good times, hard times, but never bad times. It's a great line. I mean, very romantic, poetic, like you say. Almost Byron-esque.
We were sitting in his living room, and it was right before his 20th anniversary, and he wanted to go back, take her back to the Awani in Yellowstone Park. And he pulled out his iPhone and read that to me and started reading. This is when I'm going to write this thing to her, and I'm going to put the pictures from our wedding day 20 years ago in it. And he was reading that, and all of a sudden, he is crying. He's a deeply, deeply emotional, intensely emotional person. And when people talk about, well, wasn't he hard to live with as a family guy? Wasn't he hard to work with as a business guy? Yes, but how many people have marriages like that, that are incredibly tight, faithful, in which they really sort of fit together, both the sensible side and the poetic side?
What kind of woman is his wife?
You know, she was trained at business school. She had worked for Goldman Sachs for a while, but she also lived in Florence. She has the art and the business connection. She comes out to Stanford Business School, meets Steve Jobs when he gives a talk. He falls madly in love with her just, you know, in that one talk. And they have what is a lasting, faithful relationship. She's very creative and innovative.